Days turned into weeks and weeks to months and months to years. I had gotten into petty theft, to be idhar ki udhar, conning people. 14-year-old, a class 9th, fairly intelligent student of Ramja School, Chandni Chowk, Purani Delhi. I had my pocket money from my own sources within home. Generally, a 14-year-old kid is seen playing with friends or lying in his mother's lap. But it was at this age of early teenage that my life took a turn for better. I was resolute in becoming a self-made man. It so happened that one day I had overheard my father's conversation with his childhood friend from Faridabad, Mr. Divanchand. During their hardships of youth, how they became self-made men and earned their self-respect, and so on and so forth. Idea of being a self-made man immediately stuck my conscience and did magic to my adolescence. My father did some jobs in the lean period, and my elder sister was also there to help him. But majority of the family income was earned with his business skills of trading in the field of safety razors and shaving brushes. He used to buy these products from Jamnagar and Rajkot at a wholesale price and used to sell in the local market of Delhi in retail with the help of a salesman, making good profits. Our salesman was Nandkishore. He was more like a family member, since the so-called business was being run from our very own residence, so the conversation pieces between the salesman and my father were often overheard by me. One day, I heard my father asking Nandkishore, "How many orders have you booked today?" To which Nandkishore says, "Ji, 1200 "All cash payments?" "Ji, haan ji." "Good. Supply tomorrow and bring the cash." After Nandkishore left with his sample box, I keenly asked my father about Nandkishore's earnings that day. He wasn't paid salary, but a commission of 15% on the sales. I remember jumping off the chair to what my father told me. 1200 di sale hui, to 15% 180. "Is this his regular income?" I questioned. "No, sometimes it is 200, other times 150 or even 50, and there are times when he leaves empty-handed. It all boils down to sales." As my father explained, now I knew what I wanted to do. I had found a new lease in life, that of becoming a self-made man. My two-month-long summer vacations had begun. Homework was done within 5 days of sheer hard work. One sunny morning, when all members of the family were at house, doing something or other, I went up to my father and voiced my future plans. "Maine na salesman banna hai. वो नंदकिशोर की तरह मैं भी ना सेफ्टी रेजर बेचूंगा और कमीशन कमाऊंगा." फॉर अ मोमेंट साइलेंस वॉज द ओनली वॉइस हर्ड इन दैट रूम बिफोर माई मदर रप्चर्ड इट विद हर लाफ्टर. "ओए जा जा, शक्ल वेखी है, जा शीशे च वेख के आ, वड्डा सेल्समैन बनेगा, जा पढ़ाई कर." "मोया ना, ओए कित्थों दा सेल्समैन बनना है, चल भज जा." बट आई वॉज प्रसिस्टेंट. समवेयर एट बैक ऑफ माई माइंड आई वॉज श्योर. So I asked, "If my brother can go and collect orders, why can't I?" To which their take was, "He's 4 years older than you. You can also go after a couple of years. Till then, concentrate on your studies." Somehow Dad saw the fire in my eyes. He knew that there was something there, something that made him take a chance. After all, he was a businessman. Risk-taking was something he thrived on. Patting my mother, he said, "Krishna, what's the harm in it? Let him take and try his hand on and luck on this too." Seeing Dad take my back brought a smile on my face. Before I could bask in glory of him taking my side, he exposed mummy to the problems I had faced. "He's 14 and just gone to class 9th. Dahi aayi ni, daadi aayi ni, kura jaya hai. There are 35 to 40 different items in the sample box, all made of brass and steel with different rate structure. How is he going to multiply or divide in different rates? Then the order book and the box are so heavy, about 15 to 16 kg. Or the or, he has to run around on the foot the whole day. He won't be able to do it. Tu apna magaj khapa rahi hai." But my mother was worried. "Nahi nahi. Aino mana karo, khota no ete, salesman banega." I could see those worried eyes, but I was unwavering. I wanted to do that. Nandkishore was supportive and helped me in convincing Dad. "Thanks, Nanji. This wouldn't have been possible without you." Dad asked Nam Kishore to vacate the sample boxes and teach me the rates of all varieties of safety razors and shaving brushes. I was told to put chepnya price tags on each and every sample product, having rates per dozen, like 24 a dozen or 36 a dozen. My first job at hand was to remember all the rates. The test of my skill in this art was to be conducted the next day. And I studied the entire night and morning, after when finally the test time arrived. Oh, certain to pass with distinction. Instead, I failed. All was going smooth as per my expectations when my father removed all the chepnya from each and every product and mixed the samples in the plastic boxes. Yes, tell me, which razor is 54 a dozen? Dad interrogated. I obviously was confused. He had just been one up on me and baffled me to the 10th degree. But Dad was a little kind. He gave me a week's time to prepare for my final exam. I slogged my butt off for a week. It seemed like I was preparing a thesis on safety razors and shaving brushes. By end of the week, I had done a master's degree worth of studying and was raring to go. I had done well. In fact, I even corrected my dad and Nand Kishore's faults. The salesman was finally ready and eager to hit the roads. Just one hindrance though. I sucked at math. So if a shopkeeper asks you for three pieces of a product that costs 54 a dozen plus 5% sold local sales tax, then what will be the total cost? This was only when the shopkeeper wants one product. What if he needs 4-5 products of a different range? Damn you, arithmetic, damn you, crap. But my dad had a secret trick of using number 9, which came to my rescue. Now next up were the clothes. To be a good salesman, you had to look like a good salesman. So out went my khaki shorts, and I pretty much lived in them till then. And in came my new pair of check pants, brought for 7-8 rupees at that time. The sample box was there set in order. I was handed the order book, a green colored ball pen, new clothes, pair of shoes. The 14-year-old salesman was all up to take on the world. I was with OU. My route was fixed. I had to travel some 5 kilometers on foot, starting from Fatehpuri to Koria Pul to Kashmiri Gate, Muri Gate, Azad Market, Pahadi Thiraj, and back home, Kharibawli. Phew, a lot to do. Next day, my father called me and said, "Look, son, this is a sample for women's safety razor." I was shocked to my wits. A woman needs safety razors too? I wonder why. It was called a folding safety razor. Instead of a 3-piece razor, 4 pieces formed it. It was specially made for chicks, since it could find fit anywhere, even in their purse with lipsticks and bindi, etc. The rate set for this item was 48 a dozen. I added it to the billing set of samples and left for the day's vocation. I remember leaving my house at 10:45 a.m. and had tried selling my stuff to about 100 shops. Well, it seemed that many anyway. Not an order till 3 p.m. Some shopkeepers thought my products were stolen goods, some didn't need them, some inquired more about my father, some would open the sample box, see, and then refuse. Things seemed tedious. Being a salesman seemed harder than rocket science. I was hungry. My shoes were cutting into my feet and my legs just refused to walk any further. Wanting to rest and catch my breath, I sat in front of the Tisazari goat lawn called Gokhale Market. I don't know if it's still there. A man walked by. I asked him the time. 4:20, he said. Phew. The last leg till Azad Market is still left. I thought out loud. From Tisazari, Azad Market Chowk was a 7-8 minute walk. It was famous for the dental surgeons. Huge signboards read, "Yahan dant bina dard ke nikale jate hain," and the likes. There were some 5 dental shops in a row. I saw some miniary items, as in general merchandise, in these shops. I entered it and was welcomed by the foul stench of the shopkeeper's feet. Yuck! He had his legs up on the counter and probably getting ready for a quick nap. He saw me and asked unwillingly as to what brought me there. I represent XYZ company, and we deal in safety razors and shaving brushes, and we book orders. It was a rental shop, but I guess the business wasn't quite flossing, which explained the many RE items at its shop. Anyway, he very unwillingly asked me to show the items. He was just passing time. Maybe I was too. I opened my sample box and started showing all the items one by one. He kept on inquiring about and pissing me off every item. What is the cost of this? That's costly. It's an old design and all that damn. He pissed the shit out of me. I wanted to just barge out of there, but God was by my side. I didn't. Out of 45-50 minutes of him doubting my products and me raising his doubts, he noticed a small sample of... What is that? I candidly told myself, Murga Fasa. Went forward with putting to rest his dilemma. Sir, this is a new item. Ladies safety razor. Believe those who say that behind every successful man there's a woman. In my case, it started with women's razors. Show me. Shit, this is so small. Arre nahi sir, its length increases. And I went on with my demonstration. Mr. Flop Dentist had his jaw touching the ground. He was amazed at the new product. Rate? Rupees 48 a dozen, sir, plus 5% local tax. What if I don't pay the tax? How much then? Fixed rate, sir, company rates. Payment will be in cash. Super, that will just do fine. Delivery tomorrow morning, sir. Okay, bring 3 pieces tomorrow. My joy could well be seen on my face. My smile was larger than the one on the hoarding outside the dentist shop. I don't think I had ever smiled so much in my life. Quite sparkling, considering I was in a dentist shop. I took out the order book, my first order. I started filling the order sheet when the shopkeeper halted me from writing any further. What are you doing? It is not needed. I won't pay the 5% tax. Bring 3 pieces tomorrow and take the money. I requested him. Sir, this is the first day of my life as a salesman. Let me fill the order form. He knew where I was coming from. He understood my emotions, and with a smile, he gave me the nod. I quickly filled the order form, and I still remember how it looked. The mandatory regulations of handing over of pink slips, customer copy, followed, and with a polite handshake, I was out of there. This 14-year-old had arrived. I couldn't wait to tell Dad about my heroics. Carrying my sample box and a twinkle in the eye, I ran home. Suddenly, my exhausted legs weren't weary at all. I couldn't care less for the world. I had just made my first sale. When I reached home, Nand Kishore was already present. He came after 2-3 days, since he was doing his work in the close proximity to his home locality. It was natural for him to go back home after work. My father saw me. Our eyes met, but I hid my joy, wanting to surprise him.
Oye bhai, mini salesman, ki hoya aaj? Achha, baith aram kar, detail abhi poochta hoon.
I'm sure he knew that something was up, since I actually agreed with his call. Anyhow, he went back to his conversation with Nand Kishore while I waited eagerly at that.
Nand, what happened with you during these 2-3 days?
Chacha ji, ਪਰਸੋਂ ਦਾ 175, ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਦਾ 90 ਅਤੇ ਅੱਜ ਦਾ 340, ਟੋਟਲ ਹੋਇਆ 605. 2 ਆਰ ਕੈਸ਼ ਪੇਮੈਂਟਸ, 3 ਵੀਕਲੀ ਪੇਮੈਂਟਸ, ਅਤੇ 2 ਪੀਸਿਸ ਰਿਪਲੇਸਮੈਂਟ ਦੇ ਨੇ. ਇਹਦੀ ਛੁਰੀ ਖਰਾਬ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਦੀ ਇਲੈਕਟ੍ਰੋਪਲੇਟਿੰਗ ਉਤਰ ਗਈ ਹੈ.
ਓ ਗੁੱਡ, ਚਲੋ ਕੁਛ ਤਾਂ ਪੇਮੈਂਟ ਮਿਲੀ. ਫੇਰ ਜੋ ਕਮਿਸ਼ਨ 120. ਹਾਂ ਜੀ ਜੱਸੀ ਸਾਹਿਬ, ਹੈ ਕੁਛ?
ਯੈਸ, 12 ਰੁਪਏ. And that too cash payment. I could see the look of implausibility in his eyes.
What? Show me your order book.
He read each and every word and then kept the order book aside. Took a deep breath and looked at me. I still remember that look. He seemed mesmerized, yet proud.
Come here. And he hugged me.
That was probably the tightest he's ever held me, with a heavy heart and a choked throat. He looked at Nand Kishore.
This order is not worth rupees 12, but 12 lakh hai.
First thing tomorrow, the 3 pieces of folding safety razors should be delivered to the particular shop. I narrated the happenings of my day. Nand Kishore and my 50-year-old dad heard every word of mine with intent. They were enjoying my storytelling ways for once. They were the kids, even if it was for a brief moment.
Jassi, you have earned today 1 rupee 80 paise, 15% as commission. what would you like to do with it? It was my money, my earnings. I could have done absolutely anything with it, and nobody could have done a darn thing about it. Give me 8 anas right now, and the balance, 1 rupee 30 paise, may be credited to my account. A wise move, I might add. My father took out an 8 ana coin and gave it to me. Here. Now go inside, get fresh, and don't forget to tell Ma about it. I yelled that I'm going on a food gorging spree. I went inside, changed from pants to shorts, came out jumping, leaping, and finally behaving like the adolescent kid I truly was. On my way out, my mother actually asked me to bring some eatables for the house, but my mind was like, hell no, this was my day. From Khari Bauli to Red Ford via Chandni Chowk, there must have been a single shop I didn't stop at. I'm sure I would have entered a lingerie showroom as well. Nah, just kidding. I shopped, I splurged. My gluttony made me overeat too. But wasn't that the idea in the first place? I had officially spent my 8 anas. Finito. But the will to earn more and work hard had just begun.